Hello.
And welcome to York Yesterday.
You might notice that we are not Will King or Tom Foreman.
This is true, unless I am him.
Yeah, secretly. I'm Beth.
And I'm Tegan.
And you are watching York Yesterday.
Yeah, so I've actually only been on the show once before. It was as a guest.
Yeah, you did Tegan Travels,
didn't you? I did. That's a segment I think we should probably bring back. So maybe we'll see if we can bring it back this summer.
It would be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Seeing how students travel and how they kind of save money while doing it is very important.
Well, I'm excited to see what we have on for today.
As we said, I'm Beth and this is Tegan. Our usual host, Will King, has just finished his degree, so he's quite busy at the moment celebrating that.
So, I would be too.
Yeah, so we're just going to be filling his place this weekend.
Yeah, so just coming back to the studio, I definitely haven't been here in a bit, but I do want to make more of an effort going into the end of this term, maybe into next year to try and, you know, be here a little more and I think be part of societies more. I think I kind of have slacked a bit this year.
Well, York Yesterday is the best way to keep up to date with both YSTV as a society as well as York.
Exactly.
If we use that to segue into what's going on in York at the moment, we have some local news for you all.
I love local news.
Yeah.
Because, okay, I know it's like cheesy, but like it's a way to find out like what's going on in like in your community. Because when people tell me stuff that's going on in York, I'm like, oh, that's a thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the first one I have for you is that TripAdvisor has revealed its hottest new hotels in the world, and one's in York. Question mark. So apparently every year TripAdvisor releases their top picks from around the world, including the Maldives, Brazil, and Paris, but York has still swept up a top spot with the number one guesthouse hotel on Clifton coming in at number 9.
Well, York is known for having actually quite a good nightlife. I feel like students disagree, but it's like, because we were also voted like the best place to go because of the number of pubs we have.
Well, that, and it's also safe.
Yeah.
To an extent, everyone still be vigilant out there. Learn how to fight in case you need to.
Following up from that, the second bit of news we have is that a York photographer saved a dog from a war zone. Charlie, a stray dog in Ukraine, is about to travel to York. He was found when he was about 2 weeks old, and they're not sure what breed he is, but he is now in safe hands and living his best life and coming to join us here.
Oh, that's really sweet. Well, to be fair, I have seen quite a few dogs out now that it's been sunny,
yeah.
And a lot of people are walking their dogs out now.
There's a really big, like, fluffy one near where we live, and it, like, its owner takes it on walks at, like, 7 a.m., and it just starts, like, barking at all the houses when it sees people.
It was making me sad thinking that since I'll be moving next year, obviously, like, the little neighborhood cat that I see that come by to my house, I'm like, I'm never going to see you again.
There are so many cats
around
the
university. It's heartbreaking, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. But I know that, so I did a documentary with one of our course mates. He was doing one at the Minster.
Yeah.
And actually, at the Minster, they've got dogs that, like, work with the stonemasons.
That's
so they're
cool.
They're not, like, I mean, they probably are emotional support in some ways. But, like, they're, if you just look over and see the stonemasons at the Minster, they're, like, running around and they're playing games. It's really, really cute.
Oh, I just realized I should take my sunglasses off over the opening bit and then we got distracted.
Yeah.
Just, it's summer now in York. All the sun is out, which is...
To be fair, I normally wear them on top of my head. I feel like you can't catch me in summer without the sunnies.
Yeah.
They're
also great to wear if you're going to go watch some football.
That they are.
If we move to our York City update, we do like to give updates of sport, uni and local. The football season's ended, but the under-16s for York City have recently won the GPL national title and have been announced as the under-16s champion tournament winners.
That is
which
impressive.
Is very good.
Yeah. Yeah. And I think also, I mean, like, when you're under-16, you know, like, life is also more, in some ways, overwhelming because you think you're like, I have my, what do you guess if you're GCSEs?
Yeah, GCSEs.
And you've got a lot going on and you feel all this pressure, like, do I go to college? Do I go to sixth form?
Yeah.
So that's really impressive.
Yeah, they're definitely dedicated.
Congratulations to them. Yeah, if any of them are watching, they definitely should. But, okay, I'll give another update here. The York City Football Club are delighted to confirm that Michael Morton will continue in the role of first team manager.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't really know much about the team in all honesty.
So here. I'm pretty sure they're in the same league as my local team.
Okay.
So they sometimes play as well as Max, the old producer of this show, his local team, Romford.
Okay.
And so the only time we've really kind of gone to watch them is when they play Romford.
Okay.
And it was a good match.
Yeah.
Yeah, the stadium's really nice. It's quite funny that it's like, it's next to the bowling alley.
Okay.
And the mini golf. And that's just quite funny. You go from bowling, mini golf, you go get a drink, grab a pint, and then go watch the football. And yeah, we've built quite a good relationship with them this year to do quite a lot of reports.
Yeah, but I know that YSTV is working a lot with them, and yeah, it seems like there's a really good rapport there. Yeah, do you want to read the final little fact there about York City?
Former Premier League football player Tony McManaman will also remain at the club as Morton's assistant manager, while Joe Steed will continue in his role as goalkeeping coach. Yeah.
Okay.
Do you watch Ted Lasso? Because this is just giving me very...
Yes, I do. And I watched it before I came to England because I definitely was like, maybe this will help me acclimate better. I'm finding that a lot of British people don't watch it. But speaking on sports still, looking at the College Cup.
Yeah.
So you were very involved in that last year, I feel like, when it comes to reporting with ICB. Like, can you explain to people that maybe don't know what it is?
Basically, the College Cup is a tournament run across the campus, basically, between all the colleges and lots of different sports, where they all compete with each other to see who's the best. And last year, we were there streaming netball and football. And I was at the netball game, and that was James v. James.
It's college.
But this year... currently, when it looks at netball, James is winning the A, but Langwith is winning B. So there is a little bit of difference there this year, which I'm quite excited for, and we will be covering in the future.
Definitely some healthy competition, and I feel like when it comes to West, James comes on top. When it comes to East, I think Langwith has really given a lot of the other colleges there a run for their money. So
it's sometimes confusing me what's like Hez East and what's Langwith or individual colleges, but why don't we take a look at what we got up to reporting last year and see some of the sports highlights.
Hello, my name's Tom Foreman, and I'm here for the bowl final and the Vars final here today. The bowl final is between Derwent and James, and the Vars final is Halifax and Langwith. Looking to be pretty exciting today, and I'm going to be bringing you coverage throughout. You join us here at halftime for James 6's Derwent 6's. Actually, a goal has just been scored for James right in the last minute. And before that, it's been quite a cagey affair with not actually much for either team to take. Much of the possession's been in the middle of the pitch, and actually, up till now, it's been hard to decide who could actually win this.
I think we made a good start. We've got some strong players out there today. We've got a strong squad, playing a decent James team, but I think we've started pretty well, pretty cagey. Both teams are quite anxious to get that win over the table, but I'm feeling pretty good and I think we can nick one towards the end.
For your second half, what kind of tactics are we going to see playing today?
We switched to two CDMs and one cam, so we're going to be a bit more defensive now that we're 1-0 up.
So far for Halifax?
Really well, actually. You know, we've dominated play, we've had good chances. Langwith are yet to visualise their plan, as they were putting out on all their social media yesterday. I think this should be a win for Facts, really, only if we let ourselves down. Only with Langwith are going to get back in the game, I think.
Well, thank you very much for joining me here for the bowl final and the Vars final. It's been pretty exciting. I've been Tom Foreman. Thank you for watching.
Sport.
Love a little good flashback Friday.
Yeah. So obviously that's coming in the next few weeks, but what else is coming up is a summer ball. You two have been selling tickets for a while now, and it's got a lot of different activities going on, as well as a lot of live music.
I know last year there were some really popular bands that were there, and there was a lot of, like, you had local bands and big pop bands, so...
If the group that won Battle of the Bands are going to get to perform on the main stage this year, which is very cool.
That'll be fun.
Let's look at some behind-the-scenes highlights from last year's Summer Ball with YSTV.
Hi, we're YSTV.
And welcome to Summer Ball 2022.
Right, recording. Oh my, that didn't settle well.
Let's go. We'll be right back.
watching YSTV, and this is Summer Ball. You're watching YSTV, and this is Summer Ball. This. You're watching YSTV, and this is Summer Ball. You're watching YSTV, and this is Summer Ball.
You alright, Max?
Yeah, vibes. Vibes. All the vibes.
I put it on the wrong way.
Next.
Please stop staring
last year, it was a lot of fun, and standing backstage to watch Circle Waves was very cool. Now we are joined by Ava.
Hello.
Hi, Ava.
Hiya.
So, did you go to Summer Ball last year?
I didn't, unfortunately, because the tickets were a bit spenny, so couldn't afford it. But I am going this year, so I'm very excited.
There's always a lot going on. Taking the cameras on the rides last year was probably a highlight of mine. I'm a little bit scared of heights, so getting to the top of the Ferris wheel and like clutching a camera, knowing that if I smash this, was quite scary. But it was a lot of fun other than that. Talking about tickets, though.
Yeah, so YSTV, we've been given 2 free Summer Ball tickets to give away to one of you guys.
That's crazy.
So exciting.
Oh, I love a giveaway.
Yeah, so all you need to do is, if you go on our Instagram page at York Student Television, you'll see a post that has a blank YSTV logo on it. So it's on the second bit, so you just have to swipe after the giveaway post and you'll find it. So using that, you can customize it any way you want, DM it to us, and by the 1st of June, sometime midday, because the deadline is 10 a.m. on the 1st of June, we will decide the winner. So whoever customizes it best will get the 2 free tickets. And they can be as silly and goofy as you want, or you can do as simple as you want. I will not reveal how I will be choosing the winner. So
we've had a few entries already, and I'm very impressed. Like, there's a really good one.
There's a really good one that was entered.
And I also have to say, I think like after exams and everything, it's a fun like arts and crafts activity. Yeah. I think it's a good way to de-stress and maybe win some free tickets. So send them in. I'm excited to see some of these.
Yeah, there's no harm in like just giving it a go and sending something in. So I think everyone should give it a shot.
And if you need some inspiration, we've dug up some old YSTV logos to compare.
See, it reminds me of old BBC logos and also N64, like the game console, like the GameCube.
Yeah.
It kind of, the square. Yeah.
So this came from when we first started doing stuff with 3D. And this was the logo that came. If we go to it's obviously, you can see 3 colours.
RGB who?
Yeah. We started off simple. This is YSTV40. That logo is still
quite familiar.
Yeah.
The 40 isn't there anymore.
It's because the logo we use was created like a while ago, because it looks nice. Like when it was created, it felt very futuristic, and now it feels like perfectly on brand. Yeah.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Yeah.
Oh, that one's sexy. Yeah. Who's she?
We've removed the numbers. Yeah.
Yeah, so this is the one that you're going to be customizing, guys. So give it a shot. It's very simple, see? You can do anything you want with it. So go for it.
I think a really great idea would be to take the logo, but to add 2 more rings, like just like behind it, but slightly smaller, so it looks kind of like URY. Anyway, if we're wrapping this up, one final question. They haven't announced the main act yet. If you had to pick any band to perform at Summer Ball, who would you pick?
One Direction. They can reunite at Summer Ball. Great marketing stunt.
Who would you pick?
Oh, See, I'm more of like a solo artist girly. Like, if Taylor Swift showed up, I think I'd pass away.
Yeah. Okay. How about you? Yeah. Oh, I don't know. Second Waves were really good last year. The Wombats.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wombats drop a comment on who you would think would be fun to appear.
Yeah. Anyway, before we actually reach Summer Ball, we're currently in USU Awards season. And so coming up next, we're going to take a look at some of the Love York Awards, which is the massive celebration of USU. We did a report there last year, so let's take a look at that.
Hi, I'm Meg McGuire, and I'm here with YSTV at the Love York Awards, USU's annual award ceremony. Let's go and speak to some people. Hello, who are you?
Femsock.
Yeah. Why are you here?
Vote for an award.
Exciting. Why do you love York?
It's pretty. The history.
Cafes.
Harry.
Stella.
Emma.
Why are you here?
Nominate for an award.
Yeah, that.
York Marrow.
Ooh, nice. Why do you love York?
The walls.
Ducks.
Pretty.
Everyone's saying ducks and pretty. I don't see it.
I'm Liv Woodworth.
Izzy Andrews.
Ellen Rintel.
Why are you here?
Because we're at awards.
Got invited two hours ago.
Why do you love York?
Because of the ducks. I was going to say ducks, but because of the nice people.
Because of YSTV.
Amelia Doherty.
Why are you here?
I got nominated for Outstanding Contribution to Student Life.
Nice. Why do you love York?
I live here.
Cool. So do I.
I'm Caroline.
Ellen.
Why are you here?
I've been nominated for an award.
What award?
Liberation in Leadership.
Well done.
I'm her guest.
Oh, that's so nice. Why do you love York?
Why do I love York? The people, the community, really like it. So.
Nice for some. Why do you love York?
The geese.
Everyone's saying the geese. I don't like the geese.
Yael. Lucy.
Why are you here?
I got nominated for an award.
That's nice. What award?
Student Staff Member of the Year.
Well done.
I got nominated for Outstanding Contribution to Student Life.
Well done. Why do you love York?
The bakeries.
I love the food, yeah.
Good food. I agree. Thank you.
I'm James.
I'm Paddy.
Why are you here?
So we're here with York Sport Union Committee.
That's nice. Why do you love York?
Well, what can I say? There's absolutely everything to do here, whether it's sports societies or even just the geese on campus. What's not to love?
Because roses are white.
Enthusiasm. We like that.
I'm Eleanor.
Ashley.
Fee.
Joseph.
Why are you here?
For Amnesty International Society.
For Amnesty International Society.
What they said.
Same.
Why do you love York?
York is a wonderful human rights city, and the university care about human rights because of their centre.
I also love living here.
That's a bit hard to top that answer.
I don't think I'm able to top Eleanor's answer, so I'm just going to pass on to Fee.
Has a lot of cute ducks, and the student community is really lovely.
It is.
Yeah, what they said.
I'm Katie Preston. I'm
Jasmine Moody.
Will Rowan.
Marty Stelling.
Why are you here?
We're here from York Vision and Lemon Press because we got nominated for something.
Cool. Why do you love York?
I like the geese and I like, I don't know, it's better than Catherine, isn't it?
Everyone's saying the geese.
I'm a Londoner, so obviously Yorkshire's more of a community. London's quite scary, actually.
I live in Yorkshire, it's a very cool place. Yeah.
Thanks for that, Will.
I like the Christmas shop.
Christmas shop is a good one, I will admit.
I'm Alex Sowles.
Wynn Crawshaw.
I'm William King.
I'm an idiot.
I'm Dizzy.
I'm Hannah Bragman.
Why are you here?
We are here at the Love York Awards.
Woo! Who are you all?
You already said that one.
Yeah, but all of you.
We are Radio York. We do audio.
Don't know about that. Why do you love York?
Because it's fantastic and it's a great place to make student media, isn't it?
It's all right.
I like it because it's pretty. It's very pretty.
Very pretty.
The sun comes out in the morning to burn my neck and then goes away for the awards.
Good one.
I live here.
Cool.
because there are less southerners than in the south.
Ooh.
I like the ducks and the rabbits.
Good animal, what life?
In case you couldn't tell from that report, basically the Love York Awards celebrates volunteer work across campus, whether that's within USU itself or within societies. And I'm quite excited for it this year. It's going to be a fun event to go to.
I definitely think it's something worth celebrating because I think a lot of volunteering goes unnoticed by a lot of people. And I think this is just a big opportunity for people to be recognized and to get some recognition and some awards and have a fun time just celebrating.
It's also quite fun because we've recently had our new committee and a lot of them are going to be attending. And some of that new committee today went out to do a little report. There was an art sale at a church, and let's throw over to that VT.
Hello, my name is Alex and welcome to YSTV. Today we are at the Holy Trinity where there is an art sale and exhibition happening right now, run by a lovely woman called Margaret. Let's go have a look. Hello.
Hello.
Could you introduce yourself for us, please?
My name is Margaret Dale. I volunteer here to start with, and I come once a week or maybe twice depending on what's needed. Yeah. But they let me have my exhibition here of my paintings at least twice a year, and the percentage of whatever we sell goes towards the church.
Is it true that all the paintings and cards around here are made all handmade by you?
Yes, they are. They're mine.
How long does that take?
That is very difficult because I'm actually quite a fast painter. And so I can get something in my head and then it doesn't take me long to do it.
That's really cool.
I don't like variation. What I look on YouTube.
And nice.
I'm inspired by the different things on YouTube. We do it roughly twice a year. I come at this time when the schools are break on holiday. And the other one I usually do about September, October time.
Brilliant, brilliant. So we'll see you in a couple months then.
Oh, don't wish this year away that quickly, please.
Okay, that's fair enough. That's fair enough. You were saying that some other people did the woodwork and knitting. Yeah. Would you like to give them a shout out?
My niece, Tracy, knits the animals and also the fabric ones. She makes those. And my friend's husband, George, is a wood turner and he makes the wood.
That's brilliant. You're all very talented people.
Oh, and I mustn't forget Pat. She's put some photographs in this time, so Pat's done the photography. It's due to the Church's Conservation Trust that we are here and we keep trying to keep volunteers. We want volunteers, please. But any of you young ladies and gentlemen that are students who've got time to spare, we'd be very, very fortunate if you could come.
Well, hope you enjoyed that and consider coming to the arts and exhibition sale next time it's here in York. Do remember that the Holy Trinity is actually cared for by the Church's Conservation Trust that is run by volunteers and donations alone. So if anyone has any ideas how to have a fundraising event or want to volunteer or donate, they can drop an email at york@thecct.org.uk. That is york@thecct.org.uk.
So that was very interesting. Now we are back making a lot of content post Roses. We've got a lot of other stuff coming up.
Yeah, and I think everyone, as I've been saying, exams, everyone wants something lighthearted. We've got summer ball. We've been talking about art. We've been talking about awards. I think we should look at maybe at some of the comedy side of things.
Yeah.
I think we all want to laugh a little bit. So
here's a trailer of some of the comedy sock things YSTV has coming up soon.
There's been a murder! Who could have done it?
Hello!
That was very reluctant. You're gonna have to warm up a bit if we're gonna have a good show. We are the Shambles. We are an improv troupe, so none of this is planned! Yay!
As the lights came back on, Kyle was dead. Let's see how that played out.
Oh, this never happens!
Oh, deforestation!
Oh, for fuck!
Hello.
Oh my word.
So I'm also doing the musical number in the...
Oh
happening? What's happening to me? I'm just an innocent little tree.
Before we start, can I show you something? What tree pose is better? One. Two. It's like kind of a bush, you know? Or like three, straight, like.
Look how small my shadow is! It's tiny!
I don't play by the rules.
I just love a good comedy special at the end of the day.
So that's all we're covering for you this week. However, we've got a lot of content to come throughout the rest of YSTV Live. Sticking in the same vein of comedy, we'll be premiering the second half of our sitcom series, Undergrad. Episode 4 will be followed by...
XLR, a fun music segment. Definitely check it out if you haven't already.
Yeah, we've previously worked with places like The Strand, but we've just recorded Slice, which is a little bit different. And we've got another band coming up tonight.
So definitely go check those out. And
then we'll be handing over to our radio station, URY, for Radio on the TV, followed by our social media show, Wordplay, and a new episode of How Not to Do It, our light entertainment piece.
I think the How Not to Do It's are so entertaining.
They're so much fun.
If you're a little hungover after a night out, definitely go back and watch those because it's free entertainment at the end of the day.
My favorite episode is Sunciana and Max trying to communicate in Romanian.
Well, I definitely will go check that one out this weekend. But thank you so much for having me.
We hope you enjoy the rest of the evening.
And enjoy your weekend.
Thank you and goodbye.